Hello everybody, my name is Invicta. Welcome back to our RimWorld playthrough here. You might be asking yourselves, Invicta, what is this? And I promised at the end of the last episode I would show you my personal save file base, and this is what we have right now. I will admit that after the last episode of the YouTube series aired, I accidentally saved over the newest save state on this base, which I'm a little upset about because I had a lot more stuff done. So I probably lost about maybe a day's worth of work. Like real days, not like in-game days. Because I actually had a defense system set up here in the north with turrets and everything, but oh well, that's what I get for being sloppy. And no, that won't happen to the YouTube series because I actually have that backed up, thankfully, so I avoid this. So I'm not going to spend too much time here on my personal base, but I just wanted to show you all out there on YouTube in case if you were worried that like I haven't been grasping a hold of the problems that are plaguing our current YouTube save file. Don't worry, like don't have too many fears about that, because like this is a base that I have created. Now this base, the design of the base originally was inspired by a very popular image that I found on Google image search when I was just looking for base designs, and I was like, you know what, that looks pretty neat, it looks kind of like an FTL ship. So I decided to recreate it brick by brick and block by block, and this is a one-to-one complete recreation of the image in the Google search. Now I have modified it, I've added two freezers down here, I sort of used the design of the barracks and the design of the main base as inspiration, and then I tailored it to match my specific playstyle. And this is, that's where you see with the growing fields, the growing zones, that sort of thing. And this is something that I plan on implementing in our series. I just have to get there. Right now, with the way that the game is being on the YouTube front, it is not being nice. And this, in this save file, it's also been a little bit odd, because the difficulty has been ramping up. I think it's just because I'm doing so well. But this is these are my kill boxes down here. Not really more of a kill box. I call them it's not so much a kill zone, more of like the kill Olympic rings of death. And you'll see why right here. So this is the coverage on my bottom defenses. Same thing over here. It's not exactly ideal as the one on the south, and then the one to the east here doesn't really have as much coverage. But it's because we don't really need it, because there's these two extra structures over here with the growing zones. And then I don't have anything up north right now, at least not in this save state. But I did at the latest part of the save. But again, I just wanted to show this to you, not as like I'm not trying to flex, I'm not trying to show off or anything. I just want to let everybody know and be aware of that I do understand the game up to a higher level than what you're seeing on YouTube. And by no way is this any way of saying that I'm a master at the game. I don't pretend to be, and I will probably never be a master at the game. But I just wanted to show you all that I do understand the finer points as far as, you know, dealing with base design issues, optimizing the strategy as far as like how you're going to, where you're going to place different zones and different growing zones and, you know, freezers and all that kind of good stuff. So this is my infirmary. These are my two freezers here, one on the right, one on the left. This is the kitchen. We have two stoves here, a crafting spot as well, our animal sleeping spot. I don't know why that's there. This area here was originally going to be a stockpile zone. I ended up turning it into like our animal, sort of like our barnyard in a way. What are we doing? We apparently Anna's Sinvicta's wife in this save file. Apparently she's contacting a trade to go. Yeah, I'll get a bulk goods trader. I don't remember queuing that up, but apparently I did at some point. Anyway, but this is the level that I'd like to get to on the YouTube save file, because this base is very comfortable. I've survived some of the worst instances of RNG as far as like the dynamic events are concerned with the storyteller, and I would like to get to this level. I'm not going to save it here because I honestly need to get more familiar with exactly where in this game's save file we actually were like in there. So again, I'm not doing that to show off, and please don't take it that way. If you do, that's honestly that's your own fault. I'm not doing it to do that. I just want to show everyone that I do understand a little bit of a higher level of play than what you're seeing right now in this save file, which is like night and freaking day, man. So here we are again. We are back in the YouTube series. I'm glad that Joaquin is making food. Dan, how you doing? He's consuming a fine meal. It's great. Kate, I know that she was on the verge of breaking at the end of the last episode. When is she going to get over that? One season, 5 days, 9 hours for my friend. I understand about the husband. I really think that the double debuff is a little bit kind of double BS, but hey, what can we do here? All right, so goals for this episode. Hopefully getting the air conditioning units built so people aren't sweating and dying from the heat wave. And also possibly starting work on the southern wall and expanding down here. We need to get our growing zones up. That's something that is pretty much mandatory because we're already at the 13th of summer and we have no crops to speak of. We have absolutely no crops. Even though we're not going to be able to use a heating lamp or anything for this right now, I need to put these growing zones here immediately. I would kind of like to do it inside of the base, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do that in a sensible fashion, because I do want to eventually make make an enclosure, like sort of a greenhouse. Let's see, the dimensions for the growing zones are 9 by 9 by 9 by 9. There's four of them. Let's see here. I'm not going to let these hit. I'm just trying to see exactly how much space we actually have. 9. Yeah, so it's not feasible where all the other buildings are. And that's fine. We're just going to have to adjust. Again, I don't like wasting all the fertile soil there, but at this point I don't really care because we just need to get we need to get plants in the ground and growing. So I really, really hate that this mud cannot be grown upon. Some people were saying that you can use a moisture pump. I've honestly never worked with the moisture pumps just because at that point I would rather just pick a new growing zone instead of having to, you know, to dump more time and resources into actually doing like more technology that we're already short of, if that makes sense. Let's see. Let's put this right here. And let's see if we can get a 9 by 9 by 9. Not quite there. We're missing a little bit on that front. Honestly, I'm fine with this right now. We're going to have to enclose the mud, but this is good enough. We just need seeds in the ground, and we need to be growing stuff right now. So we're gonna go potato, corn, let's go for rice, and then we also are probably going to need heal root. Actually, we don't really need heal root. We have 156 herbal medicine. Good lord. Let's go for cotton so we can get some more cloth going. Yeah, let's do that. I'm gonna put Husky back on growing because we need to get that stuff done now. Hunter lacks a ranged weapon. Who's lacking the ranged weapon? Yakin. Is he actually a hunter? I'm gonna make him not a hunter. Let's have you not hunt, buddy. Don't worry about that. I'm gonna let him cook. If he wants to help cook, I'm by all means, go for it. So Dan is helping Husky grow here. Unfortunately, Husky's sleeping in the rain, but I guess that's kind of my fault as the engineer. Kurt's researching. That's good. I may have to pull Kurt off of researching for now, just because we need to get stuff situated. These turrets, obviously, we're going to have to migrate these turrets down here towards the southern entrance. I'd like to include this geothermal geyser right here, but power, the thing is, what's weird about this playthrough is that power isn't really the issue on this save file. It's more of the of trying to recover from, you know, noob-tastic base design ideas from the get-go. But I'm determined. I promise you this. I am determined to make this remodel and reconstruction work. Now, of course, if something catastrophic happens by way of the dynamic storyteller, there's not really much I can do about that. But again, I promise you I'll give it my all. I really don't like the fact that we cannot migrate freezer units. I really wish that we could just uninstall them and reinstall them, but unfortunately we have to break them down. So that kind of sucks, but, you know, what can you do? We have a perfectly serviceable bedroom here with air conditioning that we're not using. Alright, one of the new units is in. That's going to be Dan's. This needs to be powered for Dan, because he's going to be super hot in the air. It's 105 inside. Oh, man. This heat wave could not have come at a worse time. Sinvicta really needs to get this done. Let's get Dan hooked up with power first, before anything. No, you don't understand. I need you to do that. There we go. Okay. All right, so Dan is going to start getting air conditioning. He's going to get much-needed relief. Whose bed is this? Kate's going to have her relief, which is good. I really hope she's not underneath the roof by the time we start breaking it down. Sinvicta's put the roof there, and here we go. I'm really hoping this doesn't... If he does it like this, it should not collapse. This is a little humorous to you, by the way. Okay, good. So the roof did not collapse. It's great. Excellent. That's what I wanted to see. Good job, virtual me. Alright, let's deconstruct this wall here. I hope that doesn't deconstruct the power pylons. Or the power conduits, rather. It'd be weird if there's pylons. Okay, it does not. Geothermal power, great. Good job, Kurt. That's what we needed. Now I need you, Kurt, to turn... First off, turn off this power. By the way, some people were saying that... some people were saying that they... that. The influx of power on a full battery doesn't actually control when there's shorts out in the conduits. They said it's just random that way. It's something you have to deal with. So I don't know which is which. I don't know what is true and what is not. I'm not going to try to disprove anything right now. All I'm going to say is that I'm going to try to minimize the amount of shorts to the best of my knowledge. In my personal save file, I don't have any issues with brownout or with power outages or the shortages in the conduits. So I'm not as vigilant on controlling the influx of power, the ingoing and outgoing power into my batteries on that save file as I am on this save file. So I don't know if that has something to do with it or if we just found a good equilibrium. I honestly don't know. Dan's very hot. He's insulted. Nighttime. Why are you up right now, Dan? You should be asleep, dude. He can't sleep because he's full of rest. This is going to be an ongoing issue here. I really wish Dan would hang out in like an air conditioning room. Oh, this heat wave, man, it's just all kinds of bad news for us. Repairing sandbags. I mean, that's great and all, but, like, if we have enough to make another air conditioning unit, which we do, that really needs to be done. Let's put that here. I think this is Husky's bedroom. And I think we have enough for one more. We're 7 steel short of one more air conditioning unit. And actually, this isn't even hooked up yet, so we'll have to put it over here. It'll break food binge, that's fine. I'm not trying to dismiss the loss of her husband here, but I can only handle certain problems at a time right now. Spectre's repairing, that's great. We really need to get a little bit more steel actually going here. Kate's no longer being on food, perfect. Let's just start digging over here. Just get some steel. Hopefully we'll strike compacted machinery. I don't know if we are or not. Dan's about to break again. What is... He's 59% on alcohol withdrawal. I'm telling you, as soon as he gets over that, Dan is going to be in smooth sailing mode. And I can't wait for that to happen, because good lord, am I sick and tired of dealing with this constant mental break issue on Dan. And it's not really Dan's fault in a way, but it's not helping things either. So at least 2 of us have air conditioning. Actually, 3 of them do in here. And Yakin also has air conditioning. We might have to save these barracks for now, just because we've gotten 2 new members. We definitely need someone mining, though. Whoever is not mining needs to be mining. Let's see. It's going to be Sinvicta, Nick. Nick, what are you doing right now? Consuming fine meal? Okay, you're going to be mining. I'm going to put you on mining. Regina and Yakin, you both of you can go mine as well. And Kurt, you know what? You can mine as well. Since we're not doing research. I realize that we're not doing research right now, and that's obviously on purpose because there's a lot of other things that need to be done. I'm gonna return on the power here just because there's a lot of power that's being drained thanks to both of the freezers. We don't have a whole lot of food. Actually, we're out of food. That's gonna be a huge problem. Do we not have anyone going after the alpha beavers? Where did the alpha beavers go? That's a good question. Oh, there they are. Okay, so we can probably go for a group hunt here as well. I'm just gonna flag all for hunting. Hunt, I don't care, rat, whatever. I don't really wanna mess with a grizzly bear. We'll take the non-lethal animals out. If we have to eat alpaca meat, that's fine. Turkey, we'll get them as well. Somebody said go tame turkeys for eggs, but I don't care about that right now. Let's get everyone on hunting here. I still want Husky to grow, but I also want him to hunt. So, Husky, Nick. Kate can't really hunt that well anyway. Kurt, why don't you help out with the hunt as well? Yakin, you're fine. And Dan, I don't even want to mess with Dan. We'll also get Scrubbicked on there. All right, so we should be able to... We should be getting an influx of food very, very shortly here. I didn't realize that we were that low on meat. Margarita's gotten food poisoning. Well, that's what you get for eating people food, Margarita. We're down to 4 simple meals. I'm going to make sure Kate is not doing hunting, because I want her cooking. There you go. She cannot actually make fancy meals right now, or fine meals, just because of the fact that we don't have any vegetable to pair the meat with. So, cargo pod, I hope it's good. Warg fur, hooray. Hopefully we get a bulk goods trader coming over here soon. Kate, oh, did I not? Oh, that's my fault. My bad. That is my bad, Kate. I'm going to clear this bill here. Actually, no, I'm not going to clear this bill, because if we have a second cook, they can use that one as well to help out. I think Max is going to help out after he's done cleaning. So Kate's butchering. That's good. Good, good, good. New area has been revealed. That's fine. We've got a lot of steel up here, which is good. We have enough to make another air conditioning unit. The shots you hear off in the distance obviously are our hunters. Who's better than us? It's going to be Max. Man, this heat wave just could not have come at a worse time. All right, thank you. Thank you, heat wave. Right on cue. Okay, so we now have enough steel, thanks to what we have mined, to wire up all of the new structures here for the living quarters. And in turn, this is going to allow us to look at reprioritizing our batteries. I would love to start throwing out some solar panels here to help out with the wind turbines. My personal save has kind of brought me back to the land of I really like solar power. Did we actually make a conduit? I guess we did, because I need to build... I still have not built this unit yet. Let's get that one done. Let's go ahead and deconstruct everything here. If I have to expand the production area for 2 stoves, then so be it. I don't mind doing that. That shouldn't hold me back from improving the colony here. So we'll deconstruct the butcher table. We'll deconstruct the old stove. It's unfortunate that you can't reinstall that. I'm sure there's probably mods that allow you to do so, but I don't play with mods, so. Dan, still experiencing some issues here. He's in darkness. What are you doing, Dan? Sewing cotton plant? I'm not going to stop you. Imagine if he was a night owl. Imagine if we didn't have this mood buff here, a night owl at night. That'd be so, so bad. Feeling bad, innocent prisoner died. That's going to be gone soon. My son NL died. Well, he got over the fact that his friend NL died. It's gone, so that's good. Dan just feels like cutting stones. I'm not going to stop him. If he wants to do that, then fine. If it puts him in a better place mentally, then that's good too. He gets a really bad negative effect from keeping. So this is what happens when you keep like resources in the same room, and I don't really agree with this as far as the game design is concerned. I would like to be able to designate a zone, like say, hey, this is a production zone. So storing the necessary materials to make other stuff in the same room that where you actually have people working does not negatively affect your mood, because that kind of makes things a little less efficient if we can't store stuff in the same room that we also produce stuff. I think that's a little bit silly, and this is by no means me trying to say how the game should or should not be. I just feel like, you know, I think that would be a neat little improvement there. Husky's gonna play chess. How about you take down this aggressive squirrel first, Husky? The last thing I need is a rabid squirrel going out everywhere and biting people. Good job, Husky. You did it. Husky's gonna view some art. That's fine. Yakin is up and doing nothing. Dan, what are you doing? Consuming a simple meal, that's good. And as soon as Invictive gets around to his work, he will start deconstructing everything. Banjo just ate that squirrel. You all right, Banjo? I like you. Banjo, he's been through a lot. Everyone's eating, enjoying food. That's good. gonna break stuff down, and then we will start working on what is supposed to be my apartment. And of course, the roof collapsed right on Sinvicta. You know what? You deserve that. Your rib is shattered, and your nose has been cut off. That's super. Severe illness. Regina. What's wrong with Regina? Lacks bionic body part. We'll get to that. Do we not have a Scyther Blade? I guess we don't have a Scyther Blade on this save file. That sucks. Because I would totally give the old woman a Scyther Blade. Where is Sinvicta? Are you bleeding? No, you're good. You just lost your nose. That's fine. I didn't need it anyway. No problem at all. I can tough through it. This is for steel, right? Let's get steel hauled here as well, haulers. Okay, so that's taken care of. Roof collapse. That's where everything was. That's fine, because we were basically gonna bulldoze this anyway right now, so it's just saved me a little bit of time. Let's get our what do we have most of for stone? Granite. Let's get this taken care of real quick. So at least we're making progress now in a forward motion, or at least a semblance of forwardness going here. To be quite honest, I actually have a lot of fun, like, redesigning bases and stuff. Because, like, you go from a spot to where you didn't really have any sort of structure in the way of, like, planning for what you want to do for the base. You just know where you want to get to. And now that we have, like, a dedicated goal of, hey, this is what we are going to do. We need to basically remodel the entire colony for the better, and it's going to take a lot of work and a lot of planning, but once you do it, you kind of get that sort of sense of like you've actually accomplished real work in a way. And that's a very neat thing to experience inside of a game. It's very, very rare that you get a video game that makes you feel like sort of like a sense of accomplishment in putting into this sort of work. And again, my design ideas may not be necessarily the best, they may not be necessarily the most efficient, but I don't honestly care about that. I'm not looking to be the best. I'm looking just to have fun, play games, and hopefully entertain people along the way. Severe illness, Regina. She actually needs Luciferium? I have a battery that's broken down. We have 10 components, which is good, because that's going to allow me to have at least enough to build me and Kurt and Max's air conditioning unit. Now, with the second of fall coming over, we may not need to build the air conditioning units because it's already kind of cold outside. We got Jade. Well, Jade's gonna be good for trading. Why these turrets are on, I'm not sure. Dan's still doing stone cutting. I appreciate that, Dan, I really do. 69% on the alcohol reduction. Withdrawal, anyway. Yeah, we need to get rid of this. This cloth needs to go. Because the hide is negatively affecting Dan, along with the granite blocks as well. Cargo pods. What else do we got? We've got a whole lot more sandstone and even more steel slag. I'd really like somebody to be smelting instead of doing stone cutting. So I'm going to suspend stone cutting and sculpture. How much left is on that? Okay, there's still a lot of work left. I'm going to suspend that. I'm going to suspend this stone cutting right now, and I only want Dan doing the... I'd rather him prioritize doing the smelting. He's not assigned to crafting. Why is Dan not assigned to crafting? Because I haven't done it. That's the reason why. Alright, well, Dan, don't worry about that. I will get it. Well... His day is about to come to an end. I don't want to give him the night owl at daytime debuff, so I'm going to let him go to bed whenever. He should be going to bed soon, I think. 11, yeah. So he's got 3 more hours, and then he'll be in bed, which is fine. Scrubvicta, after you're done consuming and doing your joy period. No joy period? All right. I need you to replace this battery. That needs to be fixed. I don't care about the heater up here if it's still broken. Where is that heater? This one? Apparently, I guess we fixed that at some point. Fair enough. We got plenty of wood for furniture, so I'm going to build the double bed. And then we need to start looking at expanding the colony again to add a couple more... There's still corn here. Where did this corn come from? I mean, sure, I'll take it. If Husky wants to harvest that, go for it, Husky. He's smelting steel from slag. No, no, no. How about you cut the corn? We could use some fine meals, Husky. Growing is set to a 1. Sad Wander, Regina. Regina, I'm gonna be honest. I didn't really want you. As mean as that sounds, like, I didn't really want her. It just happened to... It happened to hit me at a point of, like, I was ready to accept a challenge. And now that she's here... Sinvicta, what are you doing? Hang on a second. What is this? My timer went off, by the way. I need to make sure I get that. Yeah, no. This gets no roof. We don't need a roof over here, buddy. We just need a roof over your... Basically, we need a roof over your area and nothing else. Thank you. Psychic drone. Every colonist of the male gender winces. Oh, boy. All right, everyone. I'm going to wrap it up there for this episode. We're making progress. Slowly but surely. I realize that it seems to be the running gag of this series so far. But you know what? There's a lot of work that goes into having to remodel an entire colony, especially after everything has pretty much been ingrained in stone. So we're going to keep on plugging away. But I do appreciate the support, everybody. Hope you had a fantastic start to your day. And, of course... I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!